The Queen did not wear her imperial crown during the state of opening of Parliament today, a break with tradition on a day that presents a glorious display of British pomp and circumstance. The monarch wore her full dress and regalia, including cloak, making it the first time she has worn the full outfit but not the crown. She instead wore the lighter George IV diadem, which dates back to 1821. The decision will spark speculation that the crown, weighing 2.5 pounds, is too heavy for the monarch to wear in her advancing years. Instead, the crown was carried in and placed on a table next to her. The Queen was accompanied by her son Prince Charles and his wife Camilla in the lavish Diamond Jubilee state coach, with her husband Prince Philip having retired from public duties in August 2017. There had been fears Extinction Rebellion protesters would disrupt the event or the royal procession, but their demonstrations today during their fortnight of action were instead focused on the City of London. Colorful photographs showed the Yeomen of the Guard during the ceremonial search of the House of Lords in Westminster today as armed police officers stood on duty on the forecourt of Buckingham Palace. Soldiers from F Company Scots Guards were pictured marching to line the processional route on the Mall, while the King's Troop Royal Horse Artillery proceeded past the palace, which had the Royal Standard flying. The Queen's Colour Squadron of the Royal Air Force marched to line the route on Horse Guards Road and Horse Guards Parade Ground, as members of the public took their places behind railings near Canada Gate. Prime Minister Boris Johnson's girlfriend Carrie Symons and Father Stanley Johnson were pictured sitting next to each other at the Lords, just as they did at the Conservative Party conference in Manchester a fortnight ago. It is not the first time the Queen has not worn her imperial state crown. In 2017 she did not wear it or her robes of state to the same ceremony for the first time in more than 40 years. She was in day dress that day because it was a short speech because of the snap general election. The decision for today will spark speculation that the crown, weighing 2.5 pounds and containing 2,868 diamonds, 273 pearls, 17 sapphires and 17 emeralds, is too heavy for the monarch to wear in her advancing years. Instead, the crown was carried into the Houses of Parliament as a symbol of the Queen's authority, as it also was back in 2017. Royal sources had earlier said the crown would be placed on a table alongside Her Majesty for the duration of the Queen's speech. Instead of the crown, the Queen, 93, is expected to wear the lighter George IV diadem, a tiara that has been passed down from monarch to monarch since George IV's coronation in 1821 and is worn only for official occasions. It is worn only for official occasions, such as this state opening of Parliament. It features four crosses alternating with bouquets representing different parts of the United Kingdom, roses, thistles and shamrocks. It features 1,333 diamonds, though it was shrunk by Queen Alexandra in 1902, who removed 11 diamonds to fit her smaller head. The Queen Mother also had it resized. For the 2017 dressed-down state opening of Parliament, the Queen wore a blue outfit and a delphinium blue hat with flowers bearing small yellow star-like centers, which prompted some observers to make humorous comparisons to the EU flag on social media. That year was the first time since 1974 that the state opening of Parliament was a less formal affair, with the only other occasion following Labour leader Harold Wilson defeating Edward Heath in a snap election. Usually the monarch would arrive in a horse-drawn carriage, but in 2017 the Queen arrived in a car. However, today, apart from not wearing the crown, the other traditions are expected to be observed with full pomp. Filled with pomp and ceremony, the state opening of Parliament marks the start of the parliamentary year, while the Queen's speech sets out the government's agenda and outlines its proposed policies. The event is the only regular time when the three parts which make up Parliament, the Sovereign, the House of Lords and the House of Commons, come together. The ceremony has existed in its current form since 1852, when the Palace of Westminster was rebuilt after the 1834 fire. The ceremonial event will begin with the Queen's procession from Buckingham Palace to Westminster, during which she will be escorted by the Army's Household Cavalry. The 93-year-old monarch will enter Westminster through the Sovereign's entrance, located at the base of Victoria Tower, and move to Robing Room. While wearing the robe of state, she will lead the procession through the Royal Gallery to the House of Lords. It is here that one of the more unusual traditions begins. Black Rod, the House of Lords official, will summon the House of Commons to the Lords, but during this process the doors to the Commons chamber will be shut in her face. It is a practice that dates back to the Civil War and is said to symbolize the Commons' independence from the monarchy. Black Rod will have to strike the door three times before it is opened. Members of the House of Commons then follow Black Rod and the Commons Speaker to the Lords' chamber to listen to the speech. While sitting on the throne in the House of Lords, the Queen will read the Queen's speech, which is written by the government. Once the Queen leaves, Parliament will go back to work, with each House meeting separately to begin debating the content of the speech.